Hey there guys, Sam from Professional Music Technology here, and in this video we're going to be taking a look at the differences between four of the most popular Electro-Harmonix Big Muff pedals. So that's Daddy Bear, the Big Muff Pi, Mummy Bear, the Little Big Muff, Baby Bear, the Nano Big Muff, and finally the Big Muff Pi with Tone Wicker. So let's check them out. So where else could we start in our Big Muff shootout other than with the original Big Muff Pi? The version you can buy nowadays is a reissue of those classic pedals, the same ones used by the likes of Hendrix, Pink Floyd, Santana and countless other guitarists over the past 40 years or so. And it delivers that same rich, creamy distortion with bags and bags of sustain. Big Muffs have always been really straightforward to use. There's just controls for volume, tone and sustain. The volume control adjusts the overall output level of the pedal. Tone has got a really wide sweep, bassy and muffled at one end, right up to fizzy and trebly at the other, and sustain adjusts the amount of gain. Big Muffs are renowned for their high gain fuzz tones, so as you turn that knob up, things can get pretty extreme, but back it off a bit and you will find some really usable crunch tones as well. As this is a reissue of the original Big Muff pedal, it features the same large footprint chassis design, which admittedly looks really cool, but it could also be a bit of a disadvantage, especially if you're using lots of stomp boxes and room on your pedal board's limited. But if you're all about simplicity and you're using maybe just a few pedals, it does offer a really nice large target that's easily seen on stage. It's also worth noting that the input and output jacks are on the back of the pedal as opposed to on the sides like on most stomp boxes. Just something to bear in mind when deciding on pedal board positioning and how you're going to patch those pedals together. One addition that's been made to the reissue that wasn't on the originals is a true bypass switch, meaning that the pedal won't colour your tone when in bypass mode. It's a really heavy duty switch, and its on-off position is indicated by a nice big LED. The Big Muff can be powered from either a 9-volt power supply or a battery. It's probably also worth mentioning that this is the only model in our shootout which features a reasonably easy access battery compartment. You only have to undo the one screw to get to the battery, as opposed to four screws and the entire backplate like on the other models. Other than that, there's not much left to say. It works great with guitars and basses. It's the classic Big Muff Pi. So next up in our Big Muff shootout, we're checking out the Little Big Muff. Basically, it's a scaled down version of the standard model that we've just taken a look at, offering the same features but in a much smaller housing. Just like its big brother, it features controls for volume, tone and sustain, offering that same wide tonal and gain range and kicking out the classic fuzzy distortion that you'd expect to get from a Big Muff. One thing I will say though when comparing it to the standard model is that due to its compact design and its car chassis, it feels really, really solid. The standard model has got a bent steel chassis and there is a tiny amount of flex to it. Don't get me wrong, it's still pretty sturdy, but this one feels absolutely bombproof. For sure, it'll take years and years and years of abuse on your pedal board. As I mentioned when we were looking at the original reissue model, on these smaller footprint pedals, you do actually have to unscrew the backplate to get to the battery, but that's not necessarily a huge problem, as I'm expecting for most people, it will just live on a pedal board powered by a 9-volt power supply. Other than that, just like its bigger brother, it's got a true bypass switch, so it won't muddy your tone when it's in bypass mode, and a large LED indicator. So that's the Little Big Muff, the same huge fuzzy tone, but in a much smaller box. So far on our shootout, we've taken a look at the standard and Little Big Muff models. Next, it's time for the baby of the bunch. It's the Nano Big Muff. The Nano series are probably the most popular Electro-Harmonix pedals that we sell due to their tough, compact, pedalboard friendly design. This one, the Nano Big Muff, is even smaller than the Little Big Muff that we just looked at. Control-wise, it's identical to the previous two pedals, with knobs for volume, tone and sustain. And despite its small size, it still delivers that same huge, crushing distortion with smooth violin-like sustain. Due to its compact design, the control knobs have had to be laid out slightly differently. They're a bit closer together and are in a kind of V as opposed to being in a line. So if we're being picky, I suppose we could say they're probably a little bit more fiddly to adjust. But if it means that you can fit more pedals onto your board, it's probably swings and roundabouts, right? Other than that, the Nano Big Muff shares all the same features as the other pedals in the range. There's a true bypass switch, a bright LED indicator, and the pedal can be powered by either a 9-volt power supply or a battery, which is hidden away behind that backplate. So that's the Nano Big Muff, which packs one of Electro-Harmonix's biggest tones into their smallest pedal. So, we're on to the final pedal in our Big Muff shootout. It's the Big Muff Pi with Tone Wicker, popular because it brings a few extra features to the party. Physically, it's the same size as the Little Big Muff, so it's significantly smaller than the standard model and a little bit bigger than the Nano that we just looked at. Just like those pedals, it features the same three controls, volume, tone and sustain or gain, but it does have an additional couple of switches. There's a tone bypass, which, as you'd expect, bypasses the tone control, and a wicker switch, which when engaged, works as a top boost, emphasising those higher frequencies, giving you a much raspier tone. With the wicker switch off and the tone on, you've got a standard Big Muff circuit, delivering that classic fuzzy distortion. But switch the tone off, and you will notice a big jump in volume, offering a much more aggressive, and to my ears, a bit more transparent tone. So let's take a listen to see what those switches do. The rest of the specs of the Big Muff Tone Wicker are very similar to the other models we've been looking at. The pedal can be powered from either a 9-volt power supply or a battery. It's got a true bypass switch, so as mentioned earlier, it won't muddy your sound when in bypass mode. And there's also an LED indicator. This one's a little bit smaller than on the other Big Muffs, but still easily visible. So that's the Big Muff Pi with Tone Wicker. A great option for if you're after that classic Big Muff sound, but with more tonal versatility. We'll be right back. we've taken a quick look at all of the four pedals in our Shootout. They are the classic Big Muff reissue, the Nano Big Muff, the Little Big Muff, and the Big Muff Pi with Tone Wicker. So now it's time for a tonal comparison. As they're all based on the same circuit, they should sound very, very similar. But as each pedal incorporates slightly different components and wiring, there will be some subtle differences to the tone. So for that reason, I want to reduce as many variables as possible. We're going to be taking a listen on both guitar and bass. Those guitars and their respective amplifiers aren't going to be changing during this tone test. And I thought to eliminate any tonal changes that may come from playing nuances, I'd fire a few riffs into a loop pedal. So the audio that you're hearing going through each of the pedals is exactly the same every time. So let's take a listen and make sure to let us know which one's your favourite in the comments below.
We'll be right back.
So thanks for watching. For more information on the entire range of Electro-Harmonix Big Muff pedals, visit pmtonline.co.uk. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook, facebook.com/PMTHouseOfRock. And if you want to do this comparison for yourself, get down to your local professional music technology, where our experts will be happy to help. As always, if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you again soon.